Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we are blessed by Allah Rabbul Alamin who has given us a religion. Being a Muslim, we must know what we are quoting, the terms that we use. We know that we cannot live without a religion. Or somebody will ask us, do you think you need a religion? We will say as believers, yes, we need a religion. Nobody can live in this world without a religion. Now, if you look into the Islamic point of view, Allah Rabbul Alamin said, Inna deena indallah al-Islam. Indeed, the religion that Allah recognized is Islam. What is religion? What is Islam? It's a two different thing. It looks like two different terms, but it has the same meaning. And then Allah remind us again as Muslim. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam dina. Today I have completed my religion for you, and I have completed my favor upon you. Or today I have perfected the religion for you, and I have completed my favor upon all of you, and I have chosen Islam as your only religion. To make it easier for everybody to understand, religion means the do and the don't. Now, no one can live in this world without a do and don't. You can do this. You are not supposed to do that. As Muslim, we should at least understand what is the basic teaching of our religion. Islam is based on very important foundation. The main one is three. That is to believe in the article of faith, Arkanu Iman. Believe in Allah, believe in the angel, believe in the books of Allah, believe in the prophets and messengers, believe in the day of judgment, and believe in Qada and Qadar. That is the basic foundation of faith. Now you are prepared to accept this faith by making the declaration of faith. That's the five pillars of Islam come in. That means the shahadatain, to make sure that there's none worthy of your worship except Allah alone, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last messenger of Allah to humanity. And then the second pillar of Islam is to pray, to make salawat al-khamsa, five times a day. And the prayer is simple, is the morning prayer Fajr, just two units, two raka'ah, followed of the noon prayer Zuhur, four units, four raka'ah, followed with the late noon prayer, means Asar, four units, four raka'ah, and then the early evening Maghrib, three raka'ah, and the last night prayer, four raka'ah or four unit Isha prayer. Then you fast in the month of Ramadan. You fast in the month of Ramadan, fasting for 1 month, meaning not more than 30 days and not less than 29 days. And the month is being fixed by God Himself, the month of Ramadan. The whole world, when Ramadan come in, every Muslim will start to fast. You don't choose your month, Allah fix the months for you. That is the religion. Religion that belong to God, God fix all the ruling. If you make your own religion, then you will make your own ruling. And human have no authority to make their own religion. We just have to follow what God have perfected for all of us, what God have choose for us. That will be the best choice. The same go to fasting, and then you go for zakat, how to help the poor and the needy. And then you have the hajj, performing pilgrimage once in your lifetime. There are five pillars of Islam. Two is the daily, two is yearly, one is one in your lifetime ritual. The two daily obligation is the shahada time, the declaration of faith, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and the five time prayer. Fasting and zakat is a yearly event. 1 month in a year for fasting, one you pay zakat per year. And then Hajj is one in your lifetime. And the last one, even it is the last, the least, but it's very important, is ihsan. The religion of Islam is based on these three basic foundations: Iman, Islam, and ihsan. Ihsan means, to make it easy for you and me to understand, be sincere in whatever you do and whatever you say. Because that is where Allah values all our deeds, based on our intention. Do everything that you have to do for the sake of God, as though as you see Him. If you can't see Him, you must believe that He, Allah Almighty, see you. Then you have the sincerity in your heart that now you're doing everything to please Allah, not for other one, not for anyone else except Him alone. Because if you do something good with the intention to please somebody, this is considered shirk bin niyat. You have associated with Allah in your intention. And Allah said, وَلَا تُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Do not commit any form of shirk when you are doing an act of worship to me. You must understand your religion correctly, brother and sister. Then only you know the value. Then you appreciate how blessed we are to be a Muslim. And then you can convey the message to other people. Because now you have the understanding, you have the spirit, you have the values. Today, a lot of people only mention this and that, but they don't have any understanding about what they even say. Like today, a lot of Muslims is reciting Quran, they are making salawat, fasting and so on, but they don't really understand what they are doing. They may fast, but what do they gain from the fasting? Hunger and thirst. They may make salawat, what do they gain? It's just an exercise. So that inshallah, when you understand Islam in the way Allah wants you to understand, by following the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah, brother and sister, I believe all of you will be very proud, will feel so good to be a Muslim. May Allah bless us. May Allah guide us all. May Allah accept all our faith. And we hope to see you soon in the future program. And we hope to see all of you, not only here, but also in the hereafter. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alamin. وبالله التوفيق والأقل دعوانا إن الحكم إلا لله عليه توكلت فعليه يتوكل المتوكلون سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته